Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the first Tech Talk 2023, where we introduce the latest innovations in thermal characterization of materials. We are here in the headquarters of NETZSCH Analyzing and Testing in Celb, Germany, where most of the high-performance instruments are designed and manufactured. Today, we will show you three pioneering technologies in the field of differential scanning colorimetry, dynamic mechanical analysis, as well as thermophysical properties testing. Our experts will get you more details about these innovative new technologies now. Enjoy the first Tech Talk 2023 and the future of material characterization using thermal methods. Thank you very much.
Today, I have the pleasure to present you the most advanced differential scanning calorimeter we have ever developed. Our development team set itself the task to completely rethink the DSC. We wanted to create an instrument which offers unique modularity and was easy to use. We ended up with one concept which is available in three variations. I'm very excited to present you today the new DSC 300 Caliris family. The heart of the DSC, the sensor, the furnace and the electronic is now housed in one single module. The module makes possible to easily change the specification of the instruments by simply using a different sensor, furnace and electronic module. The module makes possible to easily change the specification of the instruments by simply using a different sensor, furnace and electronic module. But that's not all. In the future, there will be new modules for new specifications. Also, these modules will be available and compatible for the DSC 300 Caliris. This makes the instrument really future-proof. Currently, there are three modules available, which will meet all your specification needs. The high-performance module offers an unrivaled temperature range from -180 up to 750 degrees C. The module features a perfect baseline, an excellent reproducibility, and a very good signal-to-noise ratio, allowing to be detected even the smallest peaks. The polymer module is designed for all polymer applications. Extremely fast heating and cooling rates up to 500 kelvins per minute, allowing to simulate real processing. No other DSC on the market can match these extremely high heating and cooling rates. The standard module is the workhorse in this field. It combines robustness with an optimal resolution of thermal effects. This way you are perfectly equipped for routine measurements. Your choice for a NETZSCH DSC will be a choice for total flexibility. In the Supreme version, all modules are compatible and can easily interchange as needed. The Supreme version offers also the highest temperature range from -180 up to 750 degrees C. This allows the user to change the specification and feature of the DSC in a few simple steps. Another version is the DSC 300 Caliris Select. Modules of the same kind can be exchanged. This is very interesting for very busy laboratories which can't afford any downtime. Finally, there is our entry-level DSC in the DSC Caliris family. The classic version comes with the smallest footprint and with only one configuration. The classic version comes with the best price-performance ratio, so this makes this version the best device for all standard tasks like quality control. Doesn't the DSC look great with the illuminated LED status bar? One thing what was always in our mind when we developed the DSC was to create an instrument with a user-friendliness and a really future-oriented operating concept. So the LED status bar doesn't just look good. It always informs the user about the instrument status. You always know when the user interaction is needed and how far the measurement is. If you need more information about the instrument status, you can have a look to the built-in color touchscreen. With it, you can set parameters and start or stop measurements, and many more. After the measurement is finished, the evaluation can be done fully automatically, and you can have completely objective results. Let's take a look inside the DSC. Did you sometimes find it difficult to place a sample correctly on the sensor? With the illuminated cell, it is very easy to place a sample safely and correctly on the sensor. With our 100 Hz data acquisition, also very fast reactions can be seen on the measurement curve. Now let's talk about software. Since introducing Smart Mode and Expert Mode, the software enables DSC beginners to get started and expert infinite possibilities. To our future-proof concept, we include some exciting forward-looking features. Did you ever struggle to find data? With our tool for efficient data management, it is very easy to find all historical measurements. You can quickly prefill your stored data without opening the files. NETZSCH now also offers a cloud solution. It connects all your measurement methods in your lab regardless of manufacturer. LabFi makes projects more flexible and product quality more predictable. So we are very excited to offer with our new DSC 300 Caliris family a really future-proof DSC with the highest flexibility for any application and every user needs. And there is another method which is important for polymer characterization. It is a dynamic mechanic analysis. And we are excited to talk about exciting news here too.
Many material effects can be described by calorimetric measurements, but not all, and quite often without the mechanical properties that are of primary interest. This is why it's a great joy for me to present our latest developments in the field of dynamic mechanical analysis. And actually, there are two instruments I can present today. Our brand new desktop DMA 303 Plexo and a redesign of our standalone system for forces up to 4000 Newton, the DMA 523 Plexo, which combines the features of a laboratory DMA with the power you need for destructive material testing. But let's start with our desktop DMA. As we started the project, we could start from the scratch with a new mechanical design, new electronics, new firmware, and a completely new software. We did this in order to broaden the capabilities of the instrument. But we did not only improve the performance, but started the development with the usability of the instrument. We changed the position of the measuring cell. Now it is lifted for sample preparation, and the user decides whether he wants to sit or stand in front of the instrument. The instrument will adapt to your needs. But that is not all. Since the alignment of the sample is crucial for the quality of the results, we offer an illuminated sample order for perfect view of the sample. In addition, sample orders can now be changed without tools and automatically recognized by the instrument using RFID. So mixing up sample orders is a thing of the past. But now let's take a closer look at the technical principle of the instrument. Like all Plexos, the 303 has two drives, a stepper motor for static deformations up to 30 mm and a dynamic shaker system allowing for forces up to 50 Newton. And please note, this is unmatched for desktop DMAs. The deformation of the sample is measured with a state-of-the-art optical position sensor with a resolution of 1 nanometer. When we talk about DMA, most often, the instrument shall be characterized at different temperatures. The instrument's furnace and its homogeneous temperature distribution are crucial for the measurement results. So we put a lot of thoughts into improving it. We developed a silicon carbide lined furnace, which allows temperatures from -170 to 800 degrees. This temperature range can be used to characterize not only polymers, but also many glasses or even metals. A closer look at the furnace reveals that all surfaces are cooled or heated. In addition, a fan provides forced convection for even better temperature distribution inside the furnace. To sum it up, these features make the 303 a unique DMA. With forces up to 50 Newton, you can measure many samples even in tensile mode. A wide temperature range from minus 170 to 800 degrees allows materials to be characterized at very low and very high temperatures, opening up new applications. The combination of a static and a dynamic drive provides great flexibility. Whether you're interested in a complex modulus, creep and relaxation, or even universal testing of smaller samples, the DMA303 Plexo can do it. But there are some applications where much more force is needed. This is the reason why we offer the new DMA523 Plexo with static forces up to 6,000 and dynamic forces up to 4,000 Newton. Should you have larger samples, you can apply dynamic deformations of up to 15 millimeters. This instrument is also equipped with an interchangeable force sensor, so you can easily adjust its sensitivity. This flexibility makes it a versatile instrument that covers a wide range of mechanical material testing. Using a sensitive force sensor, you may use it as a laboratory DMA. Equipped with a larger force sensor, it has enough power for destructive material testing, like fatigue or universal testing. Or if you're interested in heat buildup under heavy dynamical loads, like it is especially important for rubbers, no problem. These instruments complete the family of NETZSCH DMAs. For general viscoelastic characterization, the desktop DMA303 is the first choice. For larger samples or nonlinear material properties like pain effect, more force is often required, making our 500 Newton system the ideal instrument. And for destructive material testing like fatigue or heat buildup, our new standalone DMA523 Plexo gives you all the options. For every application, the right DMA. Thank you.
Now we would like to present you a new member in our family of thermal conductivity testers, thus broadening our product portfolio for thermophysical properties, and always have the right solution for your application. We introduce our first guarded heat flow meter for highly accurate determination of thermal resistance for medium conductive samples in the temperature range from minus 10 degrees up to 300 degrees Celsius. Please together let us welcome the TCT716. Conventional HFMs and guarded hot plates mainly address insulators, thus low conductive materials, on big samples. On the other hand, the LFA technique measures thermal diffusivity, but not directly thermal conductivity, on small samples. So here the GHFM completes the family and closes the gap by directly measuring the thermal conductivity for medium conductive samples. Thermal resistance and thermal conductivity are important indicators whether a material is an insulator or a good conductor of heat. These parameters are therefore decisive for the design of thermal management systems to, for example, prevent overheating or to improve energy efficiency. Let me give you some examples. In plastic injection molding, for instance, materials with an inappropriate thermal conductivity can warp, crack, or even melt and thus lose the mechanical properties. Another example is the laser cutting process, where materials with too low thermal resistances can lead to overheating in the remaining sample and result in failure. The GHFM not only allows to study polymers, but a wide range of other materials, including ceramics, glass, and concrete, in applications like electronics, automotive and aerospace systems, energy systems, and construction industry. The specimen is placed between two plates, controlled at different temperatures, and measured with multiple RTD sensors mounted in the plates. The heat flow, which is caused by the temperature gradient, is measured by heat flux sensors, also in the plates, and calibrated by measuring a reference material with known thermal conductivity. However, due to the temperature gradient, which also exists between the sample and the surrounding environment, lateral heat loss would occur and must be prevented. So herefore, an insulating layer guards the furnace and guarantees you highly accurate and repeatable results. The TCT is designed to be user-friendly, time-saving, and cost-effective. While money becomes less valuable and worldly things are transient, your time remains the most precious good. So therefore, our TCT 716 is equipped with two sample stacks, to measure simultaneously two samples at a time. While competitive designs require an exchange of the modules to cover the entire temperature range, our TCT716 is in no need of such time-consuming procedure. The patented CO2 cooling eliminates the need of any expensive chiller unit. Simply connect a standard cylinder bottle with CO2 to your TCT716. The liquid CO2 depressurizes to form solid dry ice in your device, and the subsequent sublimation takes away the heat from your system and thus allows you to cool the sample. The optimal stack dimensions allow you to measure smaller samples compared to conventional HFM, but bigger samples than with the LFA, allowing you to investigate homogeneous but also inhomogeneous samples. The user-friendly software with automatic load control makes calibration and sample measurement an easy task for you. So why should you choose the TCT716? Because we have a robust but easy to use, time-saving and cost-effective solution for a direct measurement of Thomme resistance for medium conductive samples. In particular, we have the wide temperature range from minus 10 up to 300 degrees Celsius with a patented and cost-effective cooling system. We guarantee high accurate and repeatable results by the guarded furnace. We have a unique design with two sample stacks to simultaneously measure two samples at a time. The optimal stack dimensions allow to measure both homogeneous and inhomogeneous samples. And we have a very user-friendly software for automatic load control. So we have a handful of reasons for you to choose the TCT716.